This week's topic is wills versus trust. You know, perhaps you've been thinking about your estate planning recently. You've worked hard, you've accumulated a lot of assets, and it's only natural that you would want to have a say in what happens to those assets once you die. One question that might come up is whether you need a will or a trust, or perhaps both. First question is, what's the difference? A will is a legal document that allows you to direct how your property will be given to your heirs when you die. Now, a will goes through probate, and the probate court system will help run the assets through the system to get it to your beneficiaries that you have. An executor is typically named, and that person is responsible for carrying out your wishes. Now, a trust is a legal document that establishes relationships. The first is a grantor. The grantor is the person that creates the trust, decides what assets to include, who the trustee is or are, and who the beneficiaries are. Next, the trustee is the next person who manages the property in the trust and is essentially safeguarding the assets for another, known as a beneficiary, and distributing those assets according to the trust provisions. The grantor can also be the trustee. Now, if it is you, you will want to name a successor trustee just in case you can't function in this capacity. The beneficiary could be you during your lifetime and your spouse and or children after you are gone. If you create a trust while you are alive, it's called a living trust. These are usually revocable, which means that you can change them during your lifetime. Once you die, they become irrevocable and they cannot be changed. You need to then put your assets in the trust by titling the name of the asset into the name of the trust. A brokerage account is a good example of this. Now, IRAs and 401ks can name the trust as a beneficiary. As can be seen, both documents, wills and trusts, let you direct the distributions of your assets to your beneficiaries. But there are some key differences. Here are some. A will requires the public process of probate. Trusts are usually private. You must transfer assets to your trust in order for it to work while you are alive. With a will, this step is not necessary. A trust can manage assets while you are incapacitated. A will only works at your death. If you own property in more than one state, by placing all property in the trust, you may be able to avoid probate in each of those states. In a will, you can name your guardian of your minor children dependents. Trusts cannot do this. So having a will or a trust isn't an either-or situation. Sometimes a lot of people will have both. Good to talk to a competent estate planning attorney to discuss your needs and get the right documents for you.